If a young boy on the northwest side of Chicago sits often in the Humboldt Park branch of the public library and reads books and becomes presently intoxicated with the idea of being a writer, he then has to find his ground, know who he is, understand the significance of his choice, and be able to explain or justify himself in the eyes of the world.
Bello is very proud of his association with Chicago, so there's an indelible part of the city in his work as a writer. He was also an important connection between the city and the campus as a faculty member here in the Committee on Social Thought.
When Bello died, the executor of the estate, Janice Bello, decided to deposit the letters and drafts and manuscripts at the Regenstein, which is a terrific thing to do since he is the great novelist of Chicago.
The collection spans 254 boxes, which roughly translates into about four times the height of the dome in Mansueto Library.
It was a monumental undertaking. What Ashley did was carefully sequence all of those multiple drafts so that researchers who use the collection can understand better how Bello did his writing.
Bello was not only very prolific, he was revising his work constantly. He would change a word here or there, play with character names, change the point of view. The story remained the same, but the way in which Bello told it was malleable. The other extensive part of the collection is Bello's correspondence.
A sort of overwhelming correspondence, especially after 1975, when he won a Pulitzer Prize and then he won the Nobel Prize, and everyone under the sun wanted to contact him. If you want to know things about the life, you learn them through going through the archives.
Visiting researchers are going to make discoveries. I felt like I made discoveries too throughout this process. I look forward to seeing what comes out of this collection.